We're staying in our drawingmoreobjects.dwg file. And what we're going to do now is do a zoom extent. So just double click on the wheel of your mouse, and that'll zoom out to the extents of the visible drawn object. We're then going to go to the Home tab on the ribbon and into the Layers panel and click on Layer Properties. We're going to create a couple of new layers like we did in the previous video. So we're going to click here like so, New Layer. And the first new layer is going to be Setting Out Point. I'm going to put it in capitals. So Setting Out Point, like that. Sometimes known as an SOP on an architectural or construction drawing. So there's Setting Out Point. I'm going to change the color of the layer here, and I'm going to make this red. I'm going to use that color there, which actually is the color red, or index color one. You could put one in there if you want to, and you'd still get the red, like so. Make sure that the line type is continuous. Click on OK. Make sure that the line weight, click there, is set to default as well, just for now. And there's our Setting Out Point layer. I'm going to go back to New Layer again, and we're going to create another new layer. And this time we're going to call it Points, P-O-I-N-T-S, just like that. And press Enter to confirm that layer name. And just make sure that that is also red, also continuous, also default. Because ideally, we want to make sure that these are all set up accordingly so that they look the same. Our Setting Out Point and our Points are red, continuous, and using the default line weight. Just gives us a little bit of consistency in the AutoCAD drawing. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to look at points and donuts in this particular video. So we're going to make points our current drafting layer first. So you can double click here on the little sheet of paper, like so, or you can select the layer points and make it the current drafting layer by using the Set Current icon, as you can see it's called there in the Layer Properties Manager. It also tells you here, current layer points, and when I close the Layer Properties Manager, you can see that we have got points up there in the layer drop-down menu. Now, we're going to zoom in on this wall here. So zoom in, roll up on the wheel, and maybe pan a little as well. So just get in close like that. You want to be able to see this end point of the wall and this end point of the wall, because you can see it's all formed by one line. Now, before we put some points into our particular drawing, we're going to go to the Home tab on the ribbon. And what we're going to do, we're going to expand the Utilities panel and click on the pin there, because we need to set our point style just here. So click there like so, and our point style dialog box will appear. We're going to use this one here, that one there, because it looks the same as the object snap node, which represents our points in our drawing. Now you've got two settings here. You can have a point size that is 5% relative to the screen size, or you can set the size in absolute units. You might want a specific size. Normally though, if you stick with a point size of 5% relative to screen, that's really useful because that means every time you zoom in and zoom out, they're always going to be the same size. If you set them as absolute units, when you zoom in and zoom out, they're going to get bigger or smaller. And if you zoom out a long way, they might be too small to pick out in the drawing. So I'm leaving that at 5% set size relative to screen and OKing it. And it's that one there. OK that like so. We can then unpin the Utilities panel. We're going to go over to the Draw panel now, which is over here on the Home tab on the ribbon. And again, click on the flyout and pin it open. Now, what I want to do here is I want to divide this wall into an equal number of segments so that I can start placing some vertical internal walls in this space below the wall. So I'm going to come up here to these commands here. You'll notice I've got divide and I've also got measure. We're going to utilize divide like so. So we're going to go divide and come into the drawing area, and we're going to select this line here to divide like so. Now, we need to enter the number of segments we're going to divide that line into. And that's going to be 5. And we just press Enter to confirm. And you can see now it's placed 4 points using our point style on our points layer. So now I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 segments. And these points here are individual point objects on the points layer. And they use the object snap node to snap to, N-O-D-E. So that's how we would place some points in our drawing. So I'm just going to unpin the draw panel. And what I could do now, perhaps, is draw a line, let's say, from that node snap there. So it's a shift and a right click. That'll bring up the override object snap menu. There's node there, and I snap there. There's the node snap. And I come vertically downwards, let's say, by 2,500 using my polar tracking. And enter to confirm. Now, that is on the points layer at the moment. What I can do now is go to match properties. I'll pick my wall like so as the source object, and then select my destination object there like so, enter to finish, and you can see how I can now start dividing up my wall, perhaps using offset to give a thickness to the wall and so on. So that's how I can utilize the points in AutoCAD. Now, I mentioned the donut command as well in AutoCAD. That is not the ability to order donuts through AutoCAD on the internet, I hasten to add. A donut is a geometrical shape. Basically, it looks like a donut in plan, as in it's a circle with a hole in the middle. So let's just zoom out slightly. In fact, double click on the wheel and zoom extents, and then just pan, hold down the wheel and move upwards diagonally there. And we're going to zoom in on this bottom left corner. We want a setting out point here, or perhaps here on the intersection of our grid lines. I'm going to go for this corner of the building because it just stands out a little bit more. If I put it inside using the grid lines, it's going to be inside the wall, which is not quite what we want. So let's have a go at this with our donut command. Now, it is spelt the American way, which is D-O-N-U-T. It's also available here on the draw panel. If I pin it open, it's right there. There's the donut command. So if I click on that now and come into the drawing area, it's asking for an inside diameter of the donut. Now I'm going to go for 125, 125 millimeters, and then enter. And the outside diameter I'm going to say is 250, and then enter to confirm. There's my donut. So you can see, look, it's two circles forming an object with a hole in the middle. So if I position that, let's say, on the end point there, on the corner of the building, and click, there's my donut, enter to confirm, and there's my setting out point that I've placed using the donut command. Now, it's not on the setting out point layer that we created. So I select my donut, like so, I go to the drop down here, setting out point, click there, put it on the appropriate layer, and then just hit escape to deselect. So now, if I zoom out slightly, you can see we've got a setting out point on the corner of the building on the setting out point layer using our donut command.